petrol and the price of it is a major issue for most New Zealanders right now.
That's right. The price jumps at the pump are affecting drivers and transport operators right around Aotearoa. The question on everyone's lips, when will it end?
Fuel prices at the forefront of every motorist's mind. Across the country, 91 is averaging $2.95 a litre and $3.38 a litre for 98. Ouch! Filling up is eye-wateringly expensive, not to mention painful in the pocket.
It's insane. Like, I feel sorry for families that are on the low income level. You know, it's just going to cripple them.
It's too expensive. Like, how are you even meant to make a... How are you even meant to drive your car?
I think it's ridiculous, to be honest. But, yeah, I mean, for diesel as well, I mean, you're already paying enough for rucks.
So, how long will it last? And do you need to consider big changes in your household?
And for more on this, we're joined by Economist Shamubeel Eaqub. Thank you so much for your time tonight. Tell us, why is fuel so expensive right now?
Well, the big reason is the war in Ukraine. Russia is such a huge producer of oil, and it's been shut off from global markets. So all of a sudden, we've lost all this oil from markets, and there's fear of what will happen. That's driven up global prices, and that's driven up the price at our pumps.
Shamubeel, will prices continue to rise?
Look, you know, there is absolute potential that prices could rise a little bit more. But the bigger fear is that even if the war ends, the sanctions and those pressures on Russia might remain, and that might keep oil prices high. So we should be planning for higher oil prices for a little while. I would have thought that it is not going to go away quite quickly.
What can we do to combat these prices?
Look, we're price takers when it comes to oil, so it's very difficult for us to change things quickly. Now, for some of us, we'll be lucky enough that we might be able to work from home a bit more, drive less, carpool, car share. But for others, you might need to use your car. And for those people, I think the main thing we can ask for is either some sort of compensation from your workers or clients, or you might have to ask for a wage increase because, you know, it's not just oil. It's just the biggest increase at the moment. Cost of living has just gone up so much, but incomes haven't.
Yeah, Shamubeel, talk to us a little bit more about that. Do you reckon it's something employers will have to consider in terms of staff?
Look, right now we've got a labour market that's really tight and it's firms are finding it really hard to recruit. This is the best possible time to ask for a pay increase. And because cost of living has gone up so much and businesses are doing quite well, profits are up, this is the perfect time to ask for wage increases. And businesses will have to pay more because they need to look after their staff, because we want to make sure that they're not stressed, they're not fatigued, that they're not stressed, worried about their, you know, filling up their car and coming to work. Mm. So we are going to see these increases in living costs coming through to higher wages.
Is there a chance that these high fuel prices might actually change people's behaviour?
Look, absolutely. There's big increases in oil prices. They are going to change, see some changes in behaviour. So last time we saw that, about 2008, what we saw was people were shifting towards smaller cars. So rather than big SUVs, people were buying slightly smaller cars. But also we saw a lot less traffic on our roads. So people were driving less. So we are going to see a bit of that. And I hope we'll also see people slowly shifting back towards public transport, walking more and cycling more. But those things usually take a bit longer.
Thank you so much, Shamubeel. Great to talk to you.
Thank you.